Hi, I'm Kevin Kuchenbecker, Historic Preservation Officer for the City of Deadwood, and this is another moment in Deadwood's history. I'm here with Rose Spears, Deadwood History Communications and Marketing Director, and we're talking about what's happening in Deadwood with historic preservation. Last week we talked about a landslide that happened naturally, and today we're up here at 562 Williams, very little known extension of William Street. There's only three houses back on this gravel street behind the cul-de-sac above the schools. The resource here is circa 1900, and the owners are into some of our programs with windows, siding, foundation. But before they could do any of that work, we had to address the rocks falling against the back of the house. You can see that the earth has been disturbed here. It wasn't naturally. We actually brought in a contractor and dug out behind this house. The hillside here is quite a bowl. The back of the house really hasn't seen sunlight in over a century. We went back to the schist, which is the natural rock formation. You can see it behind me here in different colors of orange, and then brought it up the hillside, hydro-seeded, and put a drape over it that'll allow the vegetation to regrow. If we can walk back just a little bit and apologize, the dog knows we're here. Loki is his name, and I don't know his quiet command. So you might hear that in the background. But the back of the house, there was a cellar back here with the door out. What we had to do is put a concrete wall at the back of the house to help prevent that rock from falling down and damaging the back of the house. There'll actually be a new patio back here and then a block retaining wall with one-ton blocks that'll be stacked like Legos. But it has a face that looks like natural rock that'll be stained. It's called ledge stone. And that'll catch any future falling rock. As you can see, it's quite a hillside behind us going up. And well, the good thing about it, and I learned this through some of our geotechnical engineers, if you look at some of the trees, they're growing pretty straight. If you see a tree that is curved at the bottom, that's because the earth has moved, that tree is tilted, and then it tries to grow back straight again. Something I've learned as a historic preservation and some of the things that we work with when we're trying to save these historic resources. So hopefully in about a year from now, this house will be siding will be painted, they'll have finished the storm windows, the foundation, and back to its former glory of the 1900 circa. We won't be putting the cellar back in, but they will have some open space at the back of the house that they've never had. And it was something that our programs help. It's a public-private partnership. The homeowners also participate in the cost of that. Thank goodness the homeowners don't have to pay for it all, because these walls are very expensive. Without the gaming revenues that we receive, we wouldn't be able to save historic resources like this. So it's a great partnership, and once again, committed to saving the historic resources in Deadwood's National Historic Landmark. We've had that status since 1961. We take it very seriously. We're very proud of it. The City Commission, Preservation Commission, and all of our preservation partners have a strong history and preservation ethic, and we're proud of that. And that's a wrap.